So welcome again students, and today we will discuss about chapter 1 of political science, that is what is democracy and why democracy. An introduction what we are going to discuss today. We'll study different forms of the government, meaning of democracy and the features of democracy. So firstly we'll study the different forms of the government. First is monarchy. We have studied in the French Revolution also. Monarchy means when the king is the head of the country and the country has to work according to the rules or the laws made by the king. Dictatorship, where the one ruler is there, no opposition is there, only the ruler is having all the rights, citizens they don't have any right. Military rule, we have studied in the French Revolution that with the help of military, how the Napoleon, he declared himself as the ruler of the France. Today also we'll discuss how with the help of military rule, Pervez Musharraf becomes the president of the Pakistan. And the democracy is a form of government which is made by the people, for the people and of the people. We'll study in detail the meaning of democracy. Democracy is a form of government in which the rulers are elected by the people. That means after every 5 years, the people, they have the right to choose their own representatives. And government of the people, for the people and by the people. Democracy is a Greek word which is composed of the two parts. Demos, the people, kratos, the rule. That means the rule of the people. So we'll study now the features of a democratic government. First we'll study about the rule. Rulers are elected by the people. Then free and fair electoral competition. One person, one vote and one value. Rule of law and the respect for rights. So firstly we'll study rulers are elected by the people. Yes, we all know that in a democratic government, elections are held after every 5 years and the rulers are elected by the people. People have the right to choose their own representatives. In this figure, you can also see an election procedure is there. When a person, it is quite clear that he has to give vote to the BJP and the other, she is in doubt to whom she should vote. So, rulers are elected by the people in a democratic government and after every 5 years, people, they have the chance, they can change their representatives. Do you think the rulers elected by the people, they really work? Do the democratic government work accordingly? Here's an example given. In Pakistan, General Pervez Musharraf led the military coup in October 99. So, he was a leader. What he did? He overthrew a democratically elected government and declared himself the chief executive of the country. With his military power, he declared himself as the chief executive and easily he replaced the democratically elected government. He did not declare himself as the chief executive, but later he changed his designation to the president. See the power of his military rule. He just replaced the democratically elected government. He declared himself as the chief executive and later he changed his designation from the chief executive to the president. And in 2002, he passed a referendum, an official order, where he himself granted a permission. That means for the next 5 years, General Pervez Musharraf will be the president of Pakistan. And because he was doing all the malpractices, so he was opposed by the Pakistani media and the democracy activists. So when they opposed him, he passed a legal framework order. What was that legal framework order? According to this order, the president can dismiss the national and provincial assemblies. According that means president now has the power that he can dismiss the national and provincial assemblies. So now you can see with the help of military, all the powers were in the hands of General Pervez Musharraf. So do you think then elections were done? Yes. After passing this law, elections were held in the national and provincial assembly, and now the elected representatives, they are also having powers, but we are seeing here that elected representatives were there. They were the representative of the people, but still the power was in the hands of military and the Pervez Musharraf. Second is free and fair electoral competition. That means no malpractices is done and everybody has the chance to become a leader. So in India, the government of former Prime Minister Manmohan Singh, he ruled 10 long years. We all know that. But after 10 years, they were replaced by the BJP government and the Prime Minister Narendra Modi. That after 10 years, they were replaced. Why they were replaced? Because the BJP, they won the elections with a full majority. So what this means? Democracy must be based on a free and fair election where those currently in power have a fair chance of losing. That means democracy is based on a principle that if you are currently in the power and if a leader is better than you, you can easily be replaced by the leaders. But this also done. Just take an example. In China, elections are regularly held after every 5 years for electing the country's parliament. And this is the Chinese name written and the main is the National People's Congress. So, we are studying that in China, elections are held after every 5 years. The National People's Congress has the power to appoint the president of the country. That means National People's Congress, whose elections were held regularly after 5 years, they have the powers to appoint the president. It has 3,000 members elected from all over China. So what they have? They have 3,000 members and they are from all over the China. Only those who are the members of the Chinese Communist Party or 8 smaller party are allowed to contest election. See, now the rights are limited, though the elections held regularly, but those who are the members of Chinese Communist Party or the 8 smaller party, only they are allowed to contest election. Rest, nobody has the right. One person, one vote, one value. Yes, we all know that every person has one vote and having value. Democracy is based on a fundamental principle of political equality because everybody has one vote and they are having value. In a democracy, each adult citizen must have one vote and each vote must have one value. We all know that. But do you think that everybody's vote is having value? We'll take an example. Until 2015, in Saudi Arabia, women did not have the right to vote. See, they have the voting, but they don't have the right to vote. Estonia has made its citizenship rules in such a way that people belonging to the Russian minority find it difficult to get the right to vote. So, in their citizenship rule, they have mentioned that the people of Russian minority, they found it very difficult to vote. In Fiji, the electoral system is such that the vote of an indigenous Fiji has more value than that of an Indian Fijian. That means Indian Fijian is not having value, but the indigenous Fiji is the having value. Now the next, rule of law and the respect for rights. Our fourth feature and fourth and the last feature is rule of law and the respect for rights. A democratic government cannot do whatever it likes simply because it has won an election. So, what this rule says that a democratic government cannot do whatever they want to do. They have to follow the certain rules. A democratic government rules within limits set by the constitutional law and citizens' rights. That means a democratic government has to work according to the constitutional limits. But do this work? Again an example. Zimbabwe attained independence from white minority in 1980. And since then, the country has been ruled by ZANU-PF, the party that led the freedom struggle. Since the Zimbabwe, they had attained independence in 1980 and from 1980, the country was ruled by the party that is ZANU-PF and they were involved in the freedom struggle also. Its leader, Robert Mugabe, he ruled the country since independence and from independence, he was ruling. Elections were held regularly and always won by ZANU-PF. Why? But he was famous for using malpractices in elections. That is why from 1980 he was winning the elections just because of his malpractices. So, there was a law that limited the right to criticize the president. Why he was using malpractice? Because he has given the law that nobody has the right to criticize the president. But finally, in 2017, he was forced out of the office by the government. So these were the features we have discussed. Now in the next discussion, we'll study about the merits and demerits of the democracy.